Hello, this is Steve Shaw from IBM. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the custom domain creation capability of Design Management 4.0. We will create a domain that keeps track of employee information in an organization. To start, you need to enter the domain's project area, which you can access from the dashboard once your administrator has given you access. The first step is to create an ontology document, which you can access from the Designs menu. Inside the ontology document, you will describe the set of classes and properties that make up the vocabulary describing your custom domain. You must create an identifier for the ontology along with a title and a namespace prefix before continuing with editing the custom concepts. First, you may choose to model your class concepts using the class diagram. By clicking on the background, you can access the Create Class functionality, at which point a dialog will appear and you can create the identifier and name of the class. For organization, we will create a simple hierarchy consisting of employee, manager, and developer. Both manager and developers are employees, so we will specify them as being subclasses of employee, which you can do by simply dragging the connection handles from the class concepts from one to the other. We'll also create some supporting classes that have to do with the performance rating of the particular employee. You'll notice that we are removing document class from the type of these classes. If a class has document class as its type, that indicates its instances will be created as documents. If document class is removed, the implication is that instances of that class are merely fragments of another class. Performance rating is a special type of class that allows you to define enumeration. By utilizing the one-of property and adding individuals to this one-of collection, you are effectively defining an enumeration based on the values in the one-of. For performance rating, we'll add three different individuals: exceptional, average, and needs improvement. Now that our main classes are defined, we can continue on to the property diagram, where we can add the property concepts and their relationships to the classes. We'll start with the employee definition and add the properties that are relevant to employee. So every employee has a salary, so we will add a data type property called salary that points to integer. Salary is owned by employee, so we add a domain relationship from salary to employee. Additionally, there is only one salary per employee, so we have to add a concept called restriction with cardinality 1, indicating that there is only one salary property allowed per employee. We'll add another data type property called experience that is a string, so a freeform string entry can be added here. Now we want experience to be big text, so by specifying text plain, when the form is incarnated, it will come up as a large text field. Otherwise, it will come up as a single line text field. So we're not specifying experience as being required, so it will have a max cardinality of 1 as opposed to cardinality 1. Next, we will create a new object property called Review History, which stores a collection of performance rating objects. In this case, the order of these performance rating objects is important, so we will specify the range as list. And employee owns the resource objects for performance rating, So cascade delete is an important mechanism to ensure that these fragments are deleted when the property reference is deleted. Now we can move on to some of the other properties that are specific to the subclasses of employee. In this case, we'll pick on the manager concept, which has a collection of employees. So the domain is manager for this object property. And the range points to employee. Since employees is a collection, there's no need to add a restriction. For the developer, we will add a special property called skills. And it is a data type property with range of string. Again, since it's a collection, we don't have to add a specific restriction. It's implied via not having a restriction. It may be convenient in some cases to share a property definition between class concepts. In this case, we want to share the concept of a start date between the performance rating and the employee. To do this, you set its domain to be resource. The start date has a range of a date time. Now, to indicate that it belongs to a particular class concept, you need to add a restriction from that class concept to the property. So performance review will have a cardinality 1 to start date, and so will employee. Finally, we can utilize our enumeration we defined in performance rating through an object property in performance review. In this case, we will set the domain of this object property to performance review and set the range to performance rating. Since there's only one rating per review, we'll need to add a restriction for this property as well. And a rating is required, so it should be cardinality 1. At this point, we can save and refresh our diagram to give it a better appearance, whereupon it will be auto laid out. And we can see the results of our work here with all the properties and the relationships to the class concepts. We missed one thing. If you recall, the review history was set to list. Now, to indicate that review history points to performance reviews within the list, we need to add a all members from restriction from employee to review history. Additionally, since performance review is not a document class and a fragment, we need to navigate to the document diagram to indicate which class the performance review is contained in. In this case, it's contained in both developer and manager. So by dragging the connection handle from developer and manager to performance review, we create that can define relationship which describes that containment. Next, we'll need to create a formal domain definition which contains the ontology and all the supporting artifacts that make up a particular domain. Here we've created our organization domain and added the organization ontology. And then we'll automatically add the top-level classes and editor definitions that define the domain for the time being. Now our domain is complete and ready to deploy to a project area. This demonstration is continued in part 2, where we will test and customize editors for our domain concept instances.